Hello, Malt Moments. Ralph A here, and welcome to another little presentation on YouTube relating to blended whiskies, which is what we're looking at the moment. Now, I've already done a couple of very good blended whiskies because I want to help you separate the best from the rest. Now, what have we got? have you seen this before? This is one of the finest peated blended whiskies available. Black bottle. May as well pour myself a glass while I'm here. Make myself useful. And review this for you. There we go, a little screw top down there. Screw tops. Back, stay. Right. Screw tops and whiskey bottles, not a problem. You get the fancy corks and the malted and the single malts, but you also tend to increasingly see a lot of extravagant packaging on the single malts where they jack up the price. But I'm afraid the packaging does not really relate directly to the intrinsic quality of the contents of the bottle, which is what's important to us, you and me, and what's what matters. So, let the education continue. Black bottle, amber plus one, not too dark, so they've eased back in the caramel here, which is good. And on the nose, delicious, balanced golden syrup. Fresh fruit, lovely integrated meshed peat from various sources, delightful grain as well, beautifully put together and very well married. That's the single malts and the grain. This particular blend claims to have single malts from every distillery in Islay. Now, that will not include Kilhoman, which is the newest, youngest distillery on the island. Because it's not yet old enough to be called whiskey, which needs to be 3 years before that happens. But all the Islay single malts are represented here. I'm getting mainly Ardbegs and Cullilas, with a touch of Bunahabhain coming up in the back, providing a little bit of mellow moments there. Certainly very little of Froig, and not a lot of Lagavulin, but then you wouldn't expect a lot of Lagavulin when it's so outrageously popular and expensive. So, what do we have to say about the nose? Gloriously peaty, smoky, beautifully integrated, soft grain infused with the Islay's spirit custard, lemon candy, water. I have here livens up the whole event. So put a drop of water in and just gentle swirling, nothing too ferocious. We don't want to unsettle it. Give it a few minutes to settle down, and it's young, fresh, lively, beautiful blended whisky. Touch of rubberiness and butyric comes in once you add the water, but it does extend the range of the flavours. Also available, by the way, is a 10-year-old blended whisky, and if you can find it, because it's rather rare, a 15-year-old version. But this, I'll conclude by saying, this is the blended whisky that you give blind, i.e. you don't tell them what's in the bottle, you just hand them the glass to the person who really thinks they know it all about malt whiskies, and they know this and they know that. And you hand them the glass and you say, well, what do you think of this then? And they say, oh yes, it's Ardbeg, it's Islay, it's this, it's a... And then you completely bamboozle them and show them up by revealing that in fact it is a very available blended whisky. Marvellous. Anyway, what we're going to give for marks, we're going to give a rather magnificent 89 out of 100, which is as good as a mark I would give to a good malt whisky. So there you have it. join me again for a few more Scotch whisky presentations. See you soon now.